Why should you get corneal cross-linking? First of all, you're probably watching this video because you have a condition of the eye, for instance, such as keratoconus, pellucid macular degeneration, or maybe you had refractive surgery like LASIK that made it so your eye started to bulge afterwards. So unfortunately with these conditions is that it can get worse over time. When it gets worse over time, you experience decreased vision, more blur, more glare, etc. Cross-linking is a procedure that we do to strengthen the bonds of the cornea so the cornea doesn't change as much over time. It is important to get it done, usually sooner than later, because we know once the eye progresses and gets worse, there's no going back in time. I counsel my patients usually that the younger you are, the more important it is to get it done. So if you're 14 years old, 15, 16, 17, 18, 20, very important time if you are diagnosed with keratoconus, usually most of the time those patients should get a cross-linking. Now where the gray area happens is when you're older. If there's at least one good thing about getting older is that the eyes will stop changing shape. So if you have keratoconus and you're older, usually it doesn't change over time, which is good. The eye naturally strengthens, the eye naturally becomes cross-linked just over time, just due to natural exposure to ultraviolet light and outdoor activity, for instance. So if you're someone that's 60 years old, usually I wouldn't recommend doing corneal cross-linking. It's that gray area though, when you're younger, let's say you're in your 20s or 30s, that you have to make a judgment call based on what we see. So what we usually do is, in these situations, which is we're not 100% sure, we have to get done immediately, we'll measure the shape of the eye today, and we'll measure the shape of the eye again soon afterwards, 3, 6, 9, 12 months afterwards, and we'll check for progression. If we find progression, then yes, probably should do corneal cross-linking. If there's absolutely no progression, then those situations, especially as the older you get, might be okay to just monitor the condition without intervening first with a procedure like corneal cross-linking afterwards. So just know there are many reasons why to do corneal cross-linking, but the take-home message is this: the younger you are, the more likely you are to need it. And also, if you show any history where we've documented progression of it, also another reason why you should pursue corneal cross-linking as well.